Shit. Can't reach him. Don't do this! No! Brother!
Thank you.
What now?
This is drinking the ether.
We have to stop him.
Joshua!
Clive!
My brother.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're alive. We both are. Nothing else matters. I never dared hope that I would see this day.
Reunited at last.
Jill!
It is done. The demon that would tear our house apart is no more. Father.
Father.
The Mother Crystal. It's collapsing.
Right. We need to leave.
No. Wait. I owe him a debt.
Fine.
You there.
I just read on the quote section.
Little as you
take questions. Don't reinforce walls.
This is our situation.
Report, Captain.
It could be signs of spread.
Can nothing be done to call them off?
I regret not, Your Radiance. The Dragoons answer to none but His Imperial Highness. The Council is powerless to intervene.
We're hearing reports of rebel
madness is this, Theon?
Throughout the neighboring district.
Focus all efforts on extinguishing the fires around the capital. The city can wait.
What about stocks of weapons and arms?
Don't dally, man! Go!
You're idiot!
Are the doors locked?
And I want you to find out...
Make sure the doors are locked!
Movements.
By the light! Dion... Have you taken leave of your senses? Call off the Dragoons at once!
Fear not. The populace will come to no harm at their hands. I am here to save you, Father.
Save me?
A creeping darkness hides in the heart of Sanbrek. It stems from your wife, the traitorous Annabella.
Not another word, Dion.
Father, though you may not see it, the darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself. But I bid you remember, there was a time when you ruled not with cruelty, but with compassion. Why now do you turn your back on your people? Why now do you seek to stoke the fires of war? You too have borne witness to this change, Your Eminences. And you know, as well as I, who is responsible for it. A puppet now sits upon the throne. But cut his strings, and the Master loses her power!
What?
Dion, you bear steel before your Emperor? Guards! Take him!
For every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. Those were your words. But when the last of your citizens has fallen, and all of their homes have been reduced to ash, what will become of your empire, of its rulers, of your god? As the Mother Crystals crumble one by one, and the Blight sweeps in to claim all that we hold dear, our people look to their Emperor for protection. Yet he labors not to secure their futures, but to seize what is left of the Twins for himself! Even if it should come at the cost of everything his loyal citizens have labored to build!
Dion, you must understand.
A small price to pay, is it not? You've been blessed with great power, Dion. Enough to win me the world. So go, claim Valestia for me, brother.
Thank you. Dion.
Father, how he doted on his children. That he would die to protect me was plain. It was but a matter of when.
You planned this?
You did well to endure so long. But you broke in the end, as I knew you would. And now Muthos approaches. Put him to the proof. I would see if he breaks. Go, Bahamut. Kinslayer.
You cannot stay here, Mother. Come. Take my hand.
Get away from me! This is all just a dream, just a bad dream! You will not take me, Shadow! You will not take me!
Mother.
If it is consciousness that weaves your wills together, consciousness that blurs the boundary between your own will and that of others, then we shall set you apart once more. The ties that bind you shall be severed. And humanity returned to its proper place. By primogenesis shall a new age of reason begin.
Relax, Your Majesty. Don't you want to play? It's been a long time.
If that is your wish.
Men, you are as meek as all the others.
Such feeble creatures. Gifted the power of icons, yet slaves to fickle emotions which usher you to your doom. And so you bind your fragile wills with strands of consciousness. The wretched handiwork of a wretched people.
The Sons of Fire were united at last, and for but a moment, their flame burned bright. Soon, Muthos shall become our perfect vessel.
And then shall the world be remade.
Not before the bonds are severed, of trust, of respect, of love. Only when every strand of consciousness is cut away, may Muthos return to our side. By primogenesis shall all be undone. Mankind shall be rid of his wretchedness, and Muthos of his will. But while he yet clings to it, he has the power to forge bonds anew. And so we bid you. Find Muthos, and sever everyone.
To destroy that which has no physical form, you ask the impossible.
There is nothing your black blade cannot cut, Odin. We shall unite with Muthos. And bring forth a new world. So long as our vessel remains unclaimed by humanity.
It shall be done, Master. My will is yours.
How is your brother?
Asleep since I returned from the Dominion. Tyr says he should be back on his feet soon enough. For a while, at least. She discovered something on his chest. A swelling, circled in stone.
The curse. For every mountain we climb, another rises up to greet us, doesn't it?
It's never ending. Even the sky seems to have grown tired of it all.
If I disturb Joshua while he rests, I might as well.
See what Otto has to say.
see the pair that got hauled into tires.
Trouble with your gear, or... Sangfornian, dear?
Thank you.
Rodiana. Or Sangfornian, do you? No scratches, right?
Weighing you down. I reckon I can find a buyer. You got out else? I reckon I can find a buyer. Be thankful you got that much. Is that all?
Do you see the pair that got hauled into tires?
Otto, how fares the realm?
The realm? Oh, she's just fine. As long as you look past the fat storms at Mother Crystals and her skies are a roiling cesspit.
And Gav?
He's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project. Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turned foul. Still waiting on a reply, though.
Do you have any good news?
Well, that depends on your definition of good.
All right, fine. What do you suggest we do?
Oh, no, I'm just the messenger. I leave the scheme into those more suited to the task. Could be that Lady Vivian and Old Tomes have their own thoughts on the current state of things. Could be that they don't. It certainly can't hurt to ask.
I suppose not.
back in them skies, then.
Be alone when it's war. Should call back the scouts. All of them.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable catastrophe? Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate. No one could have predicted the actions of the Crown Prince.
I'm sorry I couldn't save your home.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits. They'll be back on their feet in no time.
I hope so.
Look at us. Bluer than a pair of bog crabs. Tempting though it may be, sulking will not help us find a solution to this mess.
You believe there's one to be found?
I don't know. But I am certain we're more likely to find it if we first examine the facts. Beneath these darkened skies, fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen Mother Crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces, now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves. And amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest nation would falter. Rosaria and the Iron Kingdom teeter on the brink of collapse, while the tragedy in Twinside has all but paralyzed the Holy Empire. Dalmechia fares little better. Rumor has it the ministers fled the capital after the fall of Drake's Fang, leaving their beloved republic to crumble. Walud, meanwhile, moves in earnest. The Einherjar has been sighted off Storm. The world, in short, is in chaos. It would seem our civilization was nothing but a castle of sand, to be washed away at the whim of the waves.
A castle of sand.
Not my best flourish, but it seemed fitting. The reports I've received are considerably more blunt in their appraisal. Without the protection of their nations, it will fall to the people to defend themselves against those who would take what is theirs.
Which is only ever going to end one way.
Defending a farmhouse against a band of chocobo thieves is one thing, but pitchforks and palisades will do little to stall an army's advance. Should the King of Walud deign to invade, there would be none to stop him.
None but us.
Guess. You're here about the skies.
Is there anything you don't know, Lawsman?
It doesn't take a court astrologer to augur the obvious. As for what has disturbed the heavens, that, I believe, is a question the Fallen might be better placed to answer than I. And on the sixth day, did the gods tear the sun from the firmament, visiting darkness upon their prideful sons and daughters? But I dare say you remember your childhood lessons on the sins of Zemeckis only too well.
You think they're connected? That Ultima was one of the gods responsible?
Well, he has certainly exhibited powers that we mortals would associate with the divine.
There is nothing divine about him.
But he wouldn't be the first god of whom that could be said, now would he? Yet for all the fairy tales that tell of the sins, there is almost nothing in the way of actual historical accounts. Had I the Journal of Moth the Chronicler, I may have been able to tell you more, but alas, I fear all remaining copies have been lost to time. You will forgive me, I hope?
Certainly not. Because there is nothing to forgive. Even without this journal, you've provided us ample wisdom. And we will always be grateful for it. Perhaps Otto will be more inclined to share his thoughts when he hears what the others had to say.
Clive, we have a problem.
Only one. That would be a first.
It would. Actually, there are three. We had as many owls arrive while you were at the shelves. Martha's got a cashick at her gates, and talk of monsters roaming the hills outside of Northreach has put the wind up Isabel and her lot.
And don't forget Dalimil. Lubor says the village was raided by bandits.
When it rains,
it fucking pours. The Cursebreakers are spread thin, taking stock of the damage in the Dominion. And even if I could get word to all of them, I doubt they'd get here in time to make any real difference. Which means there's only two people who can.
Jill and I.
Let them know we're on our way.
This fuss over a few dark clouds. Here, Sid. Reckon you might be just the man to help me out of a bit of bother. If you've a mind to.
Let's hear it.
Well, it's about this alembic the chief's got me making. Lovely bit of kit, it is. Bung in a solution you want split in, and it will separate it out, just like that. Problem is, it won't always get rid of all the impurities. And with some of the stuff we need it for, that ain't good enough. Which is why I've been looking for something to filter the liquid we'll be cooking off. And that's where I was hoping you could help me out.
I imagine Ty could get some use out of this alembic too.
Proper job! Okay, you...